So the ESR-REACT 5 study is an important study at this meeting for several reasons, because it's a superiority study first, and the superiority is not where the investigators initially thought it would be. This time, Prasugrel looked superior to Ticagrelor when the initial hypothesis was that Ticagrelor would be superior to Prasugrel. This has been tested in all types of acute coronary syndromes, STEMI patients and NSTEMI patients, and the data are consistent for both types of acute coronary syndromes. So this is very important. The conclusions can be probably applied to all types of ACRs. It's a win for the strategy applied with Prasugrel also, and not only for the drug, because clearly there was no pretreatment of non-ST elevation ACS with Prasugrel. Important point, because a majority of patients in this study were non-ST elevation ACS. There was a pretreatment for Ticagrelor, and we know that Ticagrelor may be harmful with this pretreatment compared to no pretreatment with Prasugrel, knowing the course data that were published before. And the second point is that the dose of Prasugrel was adjusted down in patients at high bleeding risk, for example, the elderly. This is not the case for Ticagrelor. We may have here, again, an advantage for the strategy with Prasugrel. And of course, we know that globally, the strategy of individualized treatment with Prasugrel is this time superior to a one-size-fits-all strategy with Ticagrelor, which is, I think, important. We need to reevaluate the way we use these drugs in our patients, and make sure that when we use one or the other drug, it is with the right strategy. And I think it is important point. We need to be smarter in the use of P2Y12 antagonist in ACS these days. Thank you very much.